Rossi, with Lorenzo at the front, has to come through in second place. Nothing else will be good enough. The championship will slip from his grasp.
The talking has stopped. The championship will now be decided out on the track.
And it's a dream start by Jorge Lorenzo from pole position. Look at Valentino Rossi streaming up the inside down to the first corner. It's going to be 99 Lorenzo, though, that leads the way from Danny Pedrosa.
It's a 12-point swing in favour of the man leading the race, Jorge Lorenzo. He came into this race trailing Valentino Rossi by 7 points, with Lorenzo in the lead and Rossi in fourth. That's a great fight, you have to say, from the back of the grid. And that 12-point swing puts it 5 points in favour of Lorenzo. Lorenzo's not going to come under attack from Marc Márquez. He's ridden the perfect final lap so far as the number 99 through this tight, twisty infield section. No way through here for Lorenzo. Lorenzo's going to take the championship, surely.
Jorge Lorenzo will be crowned the 2015 MotoGP World Champion. 99 wins here in Valencia.
2015 belongs to Jorge Lorenzo.
It's away. Jorge Lorenzo joins in the fun. He's up into second place as they go through turn seven to run along the top of the circuit.
Márquez taking him back immediately down towards the reverse corkscrew. Exactly as he did on the first lap of the race, and Lorenzo takes the lead. Lorenzo takes the lead from Márquez on lap 9 of 23. Márquez, a huge look over the shoulder, but once again, it is a fantastic battle at the front of a Grand Prix. Lorenzo leads, Márquez second, Pedrosa third.
They did have a long, hard look to see where Danny Pedrosa was. That's interesting. So Jorge Lorenzo leads away. He's chasing his first Grand Prix victory of the season. He took his first podium of the season last time at Misano. He's been second for the last four successive races, and he leads the way here at Aragon at a circuit down which he has never won. Yamaha have never won here either. Jorge Lorenzo en route now to his first Grand Prix victory of 2014. Yamaha, a second victory it could be. He's on the back straight, just two turns remaining. Jorge Lorenzo wins here in Aragon. Yamaha have made it two in a row. Lorenzo wins for the first time this season.
Austria awaits. Here we go. The lights are on. And away from the line we go. All three men from the front row got away very well indeed as we charge uphill. But it is Andrea Dovizioso that looks like he might get the whole shot. Lorenzo not got off to a great start. He'll go into turn one in fourth. He runs wide though, just Dovizioso. Márquez second.
Yeah, Lorenzo lost third place to Cal Crutch though. He's got it back though on the run down to turn number three. Dovizioso then takes the lead. The race winner here 1 year ago from Márquez. Lorenzo, Cal Crutchlow's there as well. Valentino Rossi's made no big inroads at the start. This Alex Rins have a great start. Rins has come from way down the grid.
Oh, Márquez there almost got hit into the back off by Dovizioso. He stood it up and somehow Lorenzo's come out ahead, Mark.
Oh, they almost touched on the straight. Did they have contact? Did their knees rub on the run up to the first corner? The last couple of years here, it's been Ducati land. Will it be Lorenzo's land?
It's Ducati versus Honda. It's world champion versus former world champion. It's Spain versus Spain. It's Ducati versus Honda. And there's no room at turn three, is there? Yes, there is. Here comes Márquez again, another block pass. And they both come to a standstill again. Lorenzo, though, clever, around the outside, picks it up and whacks open the power of that Ducati.
He knew it was coming. He knew it was coming. He just waited and waited and waited for it. And then thought, OK, oh, wait, I'm going to see you up the inside. And I'm just going to get the power down. I'm going to try and blitz away from you. This is like the Red Bull Ring 2017 all over again, Ducati versus Honda. This time around, though, it's Jorge Lorenzo and Andrea Dovizioso taking on Marc Márquez. Jorge Lorenzo's got, what, 7 or 8 bike lengths through this third sector. This is where Márquez is strong. This is where Lorenzo's been weak. But Lorenzo standing firm, and Jorge Lorenzo, he looks like he's going to protect Ducati's 100% winning record here in Austria. Marc Márquez, we know he's capable of delivering late fireworks. Is he too far back at turn 9?
This is going to be so close. We don't go down the hill. Turn 9 it won't be. He doesn't look like he's close enough unless he pulls off something special into turn 10. Around turn 10 we go. And the checkered flag awaits. Márquez is coming with the acceleration. Austria is Lorenzo land here. And Ducati win again at the Red Bull Ring.
in Mugello.
23 laps on this majestic Mugello circuit.
Classic at the front, coming under enormous pressure.
He's not looked like cracking once, has he?
No, he hasn't.
Absolutely rock solid. He's like granite at the front, isn't he, when he's there at Jorge Lorenzo. Now Marquez has got to do all the hard work again for the third time. Will he be third time lucky when he gets by Jorge Lorenzo? If he gets by Jorge Lorenzo.
Time is beginning to run out for Marc Marquez. There's 1.5 laps to go of this Italian Grand Prix. Up over the rise they come towards Correntino.
And Andrea Iannone fought his way back into third place by Dani Pedrosa. So we've got a great battle for the win between Lorenzo and Marquez. There's an equally exciting scrap for third place between Iannone and Pedrosa. It's advantage Ducati right now.
He's going to get one more chance, you feel, don't you, Marc Marquez? It's hard. He doesn't want to take too many risks. The championship is absolutely poised as we come up to the one-third distance. Up over the rise they come. Will he have another go at San Donato? One lap to go here in Mugello. Side by side they come.
5 kilometres to go. Marquez has got the inside line. He gets it all out of shape on the brakes. Lorenzo again, superb in the braking zone for the first corner. No way through this time for Marquez.
Lorenzo has repelled all borders so far. But Marquez is going to have one more go. It's not going to be at San Donato anymore. Where is it going to be? Closes up as they run across the top end of the circuit. Here he comes.
Marquez is through this time around, and he's made it stick. Now, what has Jorge Lorenzo got as a counter-attack? Marquez leads for the first time in this race. They drop down through Casanova. They'll bank it left, then through Savelli. Has Marquez timed this to absolute perfection? What have you got, Lorenzo?
Well, it's a different game now for Jorge Lorenzo. He's done all the defending. Now he's got to do the attacking. They bottom out Arrapiata 1, up to Arrapiata 2. Half a lap to go here in Mugello. What a ride by Marquez.
Marc Marquez has got all bases covered so far. No way through for Jorge Lorenzo at Scarperia. And then through Pelagio. Marc Marquez will then drop down the hill to Correntino, heading for his third win of the season. Lorenzo, though, won't let him have it without a fight. Not close enough to attack at turn number 12. Lorenzo's got to try and line him up for a move out of Biondetti. Can he get close enough to attack on the brakes at the final corner? Here we go.
Here he comes up the inside of Biondetti. What a move by Jorge Lorenzo. Marquez fights back. They're side by side coming up to the final corner, and it's Lorenzo who's going to go through. No, he's not. Marquez has fought him off. Now it is the run to the line.
Surely Marc Marquez has got this victory in the bag. Marquez, he's been magic in Mugello. What a mesmerising race. Lorenzo tries to find him. Lorenzo's got it on the line. Unbelievable. What a finish here in Mugello. Marc Marquez lost it on the line, but to Jorge Lorenzo. Lorenzo wins by 0.1 seconds. What a race. Yeah.